Amen. Good evening. Good evening, brother. It's good to see you here tonight. Would you stand with me? Amen. So now we're going to worship the Lord. Amen. Father, we thank you for this gathering, Lord. We just pray for peace in our hearts, Lord, and in our minds, God, that tonight, God, you would be here and you would be blessed, Lord. That your Holy Spirit would just move in our hearts. And we thank you for just the privilege that we have of worshiping you, Lord. May you give us peace and cleanse us, Lord. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Here am I, and I have come. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done. Set me free. Thank you, Lord. Greater love was ever shown. Better life ever was laid down. And I will always love the Maker.
Planted by the Hashana, Hashana. I shall not. I shall not be. I shall not be moved. I shall not be. I shall not be moved. I'm like a tree that's planted by the water. I shall not be moved.
God, you know, Lord, the people that are hurting tonight, Father, the broken heart, Lord, the ones that are going through heavy trials, Lord, You know, Lord, those that are feeling alone, Lord, that feel far away, may you just draw each one of us into your presence tonight. Let us know that you are a holy, loving Father who cares about each one of us, Lord. May we hear your voice tonight, Lord. May our hearts be open, our minds be alert, and God, may you just touch every heart, Lord, tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen. Why don't we greet one another tonight?
Praise the Lord. Praise God. Good evening, family of God. It's good to gather during the last week of 2022. Praise the Lord. Side note, I've shared this before, but I was at work. The 31st, when we were going to celebrate the year 2000, and all of the horror stories that were out there months before, that airplanes were going to fall out of the sky, that the computers were going to crash, that everybody's money was going to disappear because they didn't have the software set up to roll over to the year 2000, and all kinds of horror stories. And here we are 22 years later, and none of that ever came to pass. So, and these are experts in the field that just put the fear of, I don't know who, into whatever happened, but it just goes to show you. We as believers, as followers of Jesus, we know where we put our trust. We know where that is, our faith. And everybody can be running around like chickens with their heads cut off, and they can do that, and we can just stay firm on the rock. Amen, God's people? Praise the Lord. Praise God. Just a few announcements this evening. This Saturday is our New Year's Eve service, like we did with Christmas. So Saturday at 9:30 in the morning will be our regular morning service, and there will be no Sunday service. So Sunday the 1st is yours to spend with family and friends and just celebrate the new year. So Saturday here, 9:30 in the morning, regular service. As a part of our morning service, we're also going to be having communion. And as I shared, what better way to close this year 2022 and welcome 2023? Amen. Praise the Lord. So communion service this coming Saturday. Also, then this week there is no prayer meeting. Just the way things felt, no prayer meeting this week. We will resume prayer the first Saturday of the new year. That would be January 7th. And also this coming Tuesday, which would be January 3rd, the ladies are getting together to have their first Bible study of the new year. So ladies, come out. First Bible study of the new year. Praise the Lord. So that's it as far as announcements are concerned. With that, then, I will go ahead and call Pastor Mike forward. Pastor Mike?
Praise God. The Lord is good. Amen. Well, it's good to be back in the house of the Lord. We have, let me just read a scripture real quick in 2 Corinthians chapter 13. And I'm going to be calling a couple of the brothers forward, as we've done in past years. You have to excuse me, my voice for some reason is, I think I was pretending that I could sing, and I think I may have. So that's why you noticed there was no microphone there for me. It was for your own benefit. But we're going to be utilizing the leaders with an end of year thought on how on what God has for us as a body. But I want to read the scripture in 2 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 5. The word of God says, "Examine yourself as to whether you are in the faith. Test yourselves. Do you not know yourselves that Jesus Christ is in you? Unless indeed you are disqualified. But I trust that you that you will know that we are not disqualified." Praise God. As believers in Jesus Christ, the price has been paid, and we are to receive the beautiful gift of salvation through his blood as we received him, as we repent and turn from our sin and continually cry out to him. You know, we're not perfect. We're far from it. But we have a Savior to run to. And in days when things are tough, we continue to make him our focal point, and we continue to keep our mind and our heart set on the cross. Amen. So we're going to ask a few of the brothers. I'm going to ask if Brother Fernando would come forward. He's going to be sharing his thought for the new year. Praise God.
Amen to that, Pastor. Jesus is a... So, good evening. I was given the opportunity to share a few scriptures and a few thoughts that the Lord's placed in my heart to share tonight as we close the page to another year and open up another page. And as these years go by so fast, and the word that came to my mind was perhaps we could begin the year embracing the word rejoice, right? It's a new year, happy, right? But, you know, this past year, what has it, the things that has brought, the trials, and a lot of us have gone through, you know, a lot of fiery trials and tribulations, difficulty times, and really dark hours, you know, loss of loved ones, and, you know, we could consider that, put that in, you know, so the word rejoice comes in Philippians 4:4, the Apostle Paul writes, "Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice." So Paul, the Apostle, emphasizes on this word rejoice. But do we rejoice just on our mountaintops? You know, on our happy times, our blessings? Yes, of course, it's easy to do that. But what about when not in our not so happy moments and in our times and in our trials? In Corinthians 4, 8, and 9, the Word of God reads, "We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed." You see, we have this hope here. Man, doesn't it seem that way? Like, if it's not one thing, it's another and another and another, and it's like... But we have Jesus as our rock, as our handle. I don't know how I've made it. I mean, all my years without, but I know God had a plan for me, but I didn't have a hold on him, you know. But now I don't know how I would do it without. When we go through our times, I don't know how we would do it without the Lord. But in despair, like these people that, I don't know, they get suicidal thoughts, and they don't have that hope. You know, that hope that we have. In Hebrews 6:19, this hope that is unwavering, that's for sure, that's 100%, this hope that we have in Jesus. The Word of God reads, "This hope we have as an anchor of the soul, both sure and steadfast, which enters the presence behind the veil. So this is like a sure hope that we have, you know, on our good times or bad times, but we know we have the Lord. We know we have his promises. We know that his promises are true, and we can count on it, and that we can rejoice. So it's just remember to rejoice this coming year, and our, you know, we don't know what the year may bring, but I'll save this even for me, you know, I'll say this, you know what, when I'm going through something, I'll remember to rejoice. We got to keep in mind also when the Apostle Paul wrote this, he was imprisoned. He's been shipwrecked, bitten by a snake, under house arrest, persecuted, many other persecutions. He wasn't in the not-so mountaintop when he wrote, and he said, rejoice always. So it's a good example. So we'll just keep that in mind as we face the new year. Another thought that, scripture and thought that came to mind is, it's got to do with our gifts that the Lord gives us, you know. In 1 Peter, the Word of God, 1 Peter 4:10, it says, as each one has received a gift, minister it to one another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. So whatever gifts we have, sure, in the Word, our knowledge, the Word, the wisdom that the Lord gives us, continue to use our gifts, sacrificing our time, attending to others' needs, the things of God, or for his kingdom, because first we seek his kingdom, and just kindle our gifts, just continue. I mean, your guys' gifts have been a tremendous blessing for me and my family, you know. Your gifts that you guys have, we all have gifts. It's just a reminder, just to remember to use them. Matter of fact, it reminded me of this in Matthew 25:20. I wanted to read like 10 scriptures there, 10 verses, I'm sorry. And it's got to do with the parables of the 10 talents of the lazy, unprofitable, wicked, lazy servant. So in Matthew 25, let's begin with 20, and then we'll go to 30. So he who had received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents, saying, Lord, you delivered to me 5 talents. Look, I have gained 5 more talents besides them. Verse 21, his Lord said, well done, good and faithful servant. You are faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. Verse 22, he also who had received 2 talents came and said, Lord, you delivered to me 2 talents. Look, I have gained 2 more talents besides them. His Lord said, verse 23, to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. And verse 24, then he who had received 1 talent came and said, Lord, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you have not sown and gathering where you have not scattered seed. And I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Look, there you have what is yours. Verse 26, but his Lord answered and said to him, you wicked and lazy servant, you knew that I reap where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered seed. Verse 27, so you ought to have deposited my money with the bankers, and at my coming I would have received back my own with interest. Verse 28, therefore, take the talent from him and give it to him who has 10 talents. Verse 29, for to everyone who has more will be given, and he will have abundance. But from him who does not have even what he has will be taken away. Wow. Verse 30, and cast the unprofitable servant into the outer darkness, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Yeah, I don't want to be that one. I don't want to be that servant there. So it's just a reminder, even with me, I'm talking this way, to remember even our gifts, and I'm practicing to be more bold, to just share the word of God, because it's just so vital these days what these days that we're living in right now. It's just so vital to just entertain strangers or to share the word of God and practice to be more bold on, and into, you know, sharing the word of God. So that's the thoughts I had, and I want to read this last scripture in Proverbs 11:25. It reads, "The generous soul will be made rich, and he who waters will also be watered." So it's rich in spirit. We're rich in spirit, and if we water, the Lord waters us. So just remember to rejoice and kindle our gifts and use them and be used by the word of God, as our pastor says, as a utensil and a tool in God's hands. You know, remember to just to be used in that manner. So I'll leave you with that, and thank you for the opportunity to share a few thoughts and scriptures for the new year.
Praise God. That was really good. The word of God is so clear, and it blesses us. It blesses us so much when it's plain for us to just receive, even as this. I'm sorry. Even as the parable, speaking of what we have, the talents that we have. And what was the servant who just buried it? It was just doing nothing. So it's getting what God gave us and doing nothing. You know, we can, even at our lowest, or at least I should say, even our least amount of applying ourselves, the word of God says, put it in a bank. Let it accumulate interest. Even you not utilizing what you have will still bring something more than what I gave you. So even for us to even be here together, that's something that's very important. But to take what we have and to use it, and like Brother Fernando said, pouring into each other, being able to be used, taking those gifts and pouring them into the body. And that's what even tonight is. I mean, that's how God brought me into this body, as a visitor. And God opened a door and allowed me to become a deacon and called me to that position, and then called me to the position of an elder. And then by God's grace, he put me in the position of assistant pastor, and God called our pastor home, and that's how these things worked out. So even as we hear the word of God from these men, this could be God preparing if he tarries, the pastor for our future, or for your future. I'll be home. We don't know. You might be home too. It says we're not promised tomorrow. So, and we might all be taken into the cloud tonight if we're ready. So praise God. So I thank you for that, brother. That was a blessing. Right now, I'm going to go ahead and call brother Javier Ford. Praise God. Thank you.
Amen, amen. Thank you. You know, So there's a every year, you know, New Year's resolutions. I do kind of challenge myself to do New Year's resolutions, because I'm competitive, and I just like to be challenged. And and some of those things I know I look back at and I go, man, I didn't fulfill any of those things I wanted for myself. And I don't dwell on them, but I'm like, man. So it seems like though I have to, my New Year's resolution is kind of repetitive at times. But, you know, the Lord, I wasn't even thinking of that, but the Lord put in my heart, he goes, and what, move forward. And in Psalms 37, 20, verse 23 and 24, we'll go there, right? And the Lord is just putting things in my heart as I was praying, and I was just seeking him to, on what to share about. And this is is actually a hymn song that we actually sing too. It says in verse 23, it says, "The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his way. Though he fall, he will not be cast down, for the Lord upholds him with his hand." And some, you know, even though we want to look back at some of the things that we maybe fail at, I feel that the Lord is constantly showing us to, you know, move forward. You know, what is it that, you know, that the Lord wanted me to bring forth today? And it's funny when you start to dwell on these things and you start thinking about these things, they sound so good in your head. But when you start writing them down, you're like, yeah, that sounds good. And then I'm up here and I'm like, man, why can't I have that same thought? Those thoughts are leaving me. But man, I guess it's nerves or something. I don't know. Yeah. You know, and I'm not saying that, you know, I'm a good man, because even when we feel that, you know, that we're good, you know, the Lord reminds us of what he's brought us out of. And we kind of see that wickedness, even though I can't say that I was a bad man in any way, in any sense, but we know ourselves and we know that a lot of things in ourselves are not good, and how we think and how our mind thinks. And we know that the Lord took, you know, he called us and he brought us forth to his kingdom. And we know that, man, it just took away a lot of what I could have done wrong, and all the sins that could have been brought forth me before me. I know I got saved when I was 21, and that's a time where everybody wants to live life and feel that they reach the age where they can do as they please and what they please to. But the Lord called me. He called me, and I was 20, right at 21, and now, instead of looking at, you know, we look at the past and those things, how you were so excited when we got saved, and we can look at those things and say, but as you're walking with the Lord, you're saying, okay, Lord, what is it you have for me? And before you know it, you're married, then you have kids, and then the joy of just raising them and just doing things with them, it's just so exciting. And I just thank the Lord for that. But I just want to look forward and say, well, Lord, what is it you have for me? What is it you're setting before me? In Isaiah 43:18 and 19. It says, do not remember the former things, nor consider those things of old. Behold, he goes, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? He says, I will even make the road in the wilderness and the rivers in the desert. And he's just refreshing our lives. He's making ways for us to go through to the things that we see as so difficult in our lives. He's paving our ways and he's making those things easier before us, as we may have saw them as just this big hurdle in our lives. And, you know, just moving forward is just that we see that when every time the Lord opens a door for us, it's just we know that it was him. I remember working at UPS, and I would drive by Toyota, and this is when me and Amanda first got married, and I would drive over here to Fontana, so I would go a different way, and I would say, man, that'd be cool to work there. And I remember trying to get there because it was the job to have a Toyota, you know, to go through Toyota, and I go, Lord, that'd be cool to, you know, to work there. It was just a thought. I didn't think nothing of it. And I know at UPS, I was going through so much struggle, and it wasn't so much the work. The work was easy, but it's when, you know, at work is, you have to deal with a lot of different personalities and people who are not like you, not the same, you know, not Christians, not, you know, they have, you know, they're worldly and how they talk and how they talk to you. The authority, you having to be under them as far as authority and how they speak to you, it's not the same how you would be see as respectful. And even the vulgarness that you even surround yourself with, and you're like, I was like, man, and I was like, man, Lord, I don't want to work here no more. But I was like, you know what? I'm just going to keep going to school and see what happens. And there was a brother that was coming here, and he goes, hey, I have this flyer for you. And I go, what is it? He goes, hey, Toyota's hiring. I went like, oh. I go, well, I'm going to school. You know, I'm not really that interested. And I go, because I was, you know, I thought I was being obedient and going to school. And I was like, all right. And the flyer said, do not show up before 6. I go, okay. I paid attention to the flyer. It says, do not show up before 6. And then I remember going, and I saw the line. It was from the door to AM/PM. If you guys remember AM/PM, it was huge. And I told myself, I'm going home. So I turn to right, and I'm stuck behind all these cars and waiting to get through. And I go through this little turnaround about. Security guy knocks on my window, and he goes, here's your ticket. I go, what is this for? He goes, well, you need a ticket to get an application. I go, oh, I guess I'm staying. So, and I did that. And 4 months later, before you know it, you know, I'm hired at Toyota. I'm like, wow. And it wasn't anything I was looking for, but I remember that thought. As I would go by Toyota, I would go, Lord, that would be cool to work there. And the Lord has opened that door, and even the hurdles, even just getting away from, I enjoyed working at UPS. I loved it. It was just, as you know, sometimes people make it difficult for you to work at a certain place and a certain time. And I just know that the Lord opened that opportunity for me. And even as the Lord continues to challenge us, as I like to be challenged, you know, from year to year to set goals for myself. And what can I do? What is it that, Lord, that you want me to do for you? How can I better myself as in the Lord? You know, I remember way back where I struggled paying tithes and I go, Lord, I'm just going to do it. And now it's a faithfulness that's already naturally embedded in me. And I remember struggling with it though. I would say, man, and when things were going wrong, I'd be like, it's because I didn't pay my tithes. I know it. So I don't know, things you just kind of put in your head and think you're trying to do things right. But it's funny how we condemn ourselves at times too. But as in Luke 9, 62. And Jesus said to them, and it says, no one having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. And I say that because just as in Hebrews, where it says that the man running the race with endurance, because it's not easy. You know, it's not easy. I'm not saying it's not easy walking with the Lord. It's not easy. But the things, the discipline that we have to do to strengthen ourselves, to be disciplined into prayer, to be disciplined to read your word, be disciplined to love your family, and you know, some of those things are not natural, you know, for me, or even some of you who maybe didn't grow up having that, and sometimes even Amanda, you know, struggles with me not doing something because it just doesn't come natural that way. But being disciplined and knowing that, you know what, I have to show more affection. I have to go to my brethren. We have a little prayer meeting. I have to be disciplined in meeting the brethren there to have fellowship with them, to just have a prayer meetings with them, to pray for others when the Lord prompts you. You say you want to be used by the Lord will prompt our hearts and put people in our hearts to pray for them. But we got to be obedient. We got to listen to the Holy Spirit and say, you know what? Hey, the Lord is asking me to pray for this person. I'm going to pray for them. Why? I don't know. Fernando walked through the door. He goes, hey, I was praying for you. I go, why? He goes, because we're going to share today. I was like, hey, the Lord put that in his heart. He probably, I didn't pray for you, brother, but thank you. You know, but you know, it was, I'm glad he did because yeah, it's very nerve wracking. It's scary being up here, but you know, those are the disciplines. Those are the things that the Lord is, he puts in our hearts, and he shows us that, hey, we need to lift one another up, to go forward, move forward, to lift, to be obedient to the Holy Spirit, to be obedient to what the Lord is showing us in his word. And as deacons, there's a format, and I don't remember in which gospel it is, but how deacons or in the epistles were, how we should conduct ourselves. And, you know, it's laid out. You know, we need to be disciplined in that. We need to follow those guidelines that were set before, you know, by our forefathers to do them. And those are the things that that I pray that we continue moving forward in. And that I pray, you know, like Fernando was saying, that you know, as I say, what does the Lord want for me or to share with you guys is what, hey, what do I need to do? And as I say, I like to be challenged, and I also ask you guys, challenge me. Call me, you know, we get challenged by others and say, hey, help me out with this, or I'm open, I'm available to it, and I'm asking you guys, I'm even giving you guys permission to challenge me if you feel to do things, to obviously to build my character, to and to you know, see what the Lord has for me. So I'm going to read in Hebrews just the running the race, Hebrews 12, 1 and 2. And I'll end it with this one. It says, run the race of faith. Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight, the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who, for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross, despised the shame, and he sat at the right hand of the throne of God. And even the endurance, even as a runner has to run with endurance, there's discipline behind and getting himself ready for that race. And likewise, myself too. I challenge myself again. I need to be disciplined in a lot of things that I'm not disciplined in, and a lot of dying to myself, to making that happen. Discipline, not only strength, but in intake, the word, worship, and you know, I like listening to, you know, right now the Greg Laurie in the morning as I go to work, and I get challenged by him. He shares really well, and just having more of that in my life, and I just feel that we need to move forward. I need to move forward and continue walking straight. I remember there's a brother, he would say, he goes, hey, if you fall forward, so that you move forward in the Lord. So I always remember that at a men's retreat, he shared that. And so I just thank you. Amen.
Praise God. That was good. I feel it's necessary as a church to have a church disclaimer that his sweatshirt does not represent the church in any way. The Green Bay Packers, we know we're a church of Charger fans. No, I'm just playing. But that's truly a beautiful word to be able to rejoice in, as Brother Fernando said, and to continue to be faithful in. And we don't know what God has for us. It's amazing. The scripture came to mind in Psalms 37, verse 1, it says, do not fret because of evildoers, nor be envious of workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and feed on his faithfulness. Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. Commit your ways to the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. He shall bring forth your righteousness as the light and your justice as the noonday. Praise God. That's tremendous. I know how he shared how faithful God is. Sometimes we don't even realize that these desires of our heart can just be passing. He just said, it'd be nice to do that. Work at Toyota. And God heard the desire of his heart. And his faithfulness didn't go into exactly, trying to put himself in a position for that job. But he was obedient. When the door opened, he went through it. I remember sharing with my wife when I was a lechero. I was a milkman for Driftwood Dairy. And I remember delivering to schools out here. And I was delivering to school in the middle of the night here in Ranch Cucamonga. And I remembered looking at the playground as I was leaving the school thinking, man, I'd like to bring my kids here. So the playgrounds in Whittier by my house didn't look like that. Where I grew up, they didn't look like any of that. But I thought of those things. And I thought, wow, what a beautiful thing it would be to bring. And I remember sharing that with my wife that maybe, we'll drive out there and take the kids. And then as God opened doors and blessed me with a job out in this direction, working for the school district, and then I met a brother named Gene Martinez who served God here for many years. Now he's serving God out of state in Utah, but we know he loves the Lord. And he invited me to a church called The Rock. And I visited, and then he invited me to a park outing as we came. And the park outing was at that park, and it was Hermosa Park. And I said, look at how God is so faithful. Just some small little thought. It didn't mean anything to anybody else. It was just something within me. And then to be able to sit there and stand at the park and see all these hallelujahs, all these Christians loving the Lord and just rejoicing and having a great time. And my kids were playing on the toys, and I'm thinking, wow, look at how God gives us the desires of our heart. Even when it's not, we think of salvation, and we think of the major things in life we're providing for. God says, I got it all under control. I'll even give you the little things, even the small things like that. So God's faithfulness is just tremendous. And these two brothers really blessed my heart tonight. I know Brother Victor was going to be sharing tonight as well, but I'm sure we'll be able to utilize him at a different date. So I'm going to call the Brother Regis forward, and we're going to ask you to stand. And we always want to give opportunity for prayer before we close. So we're going to open the altar. And if there's anything on your heart, I know that we're coming into a new year, and everybody has different thoughts, and as Brother Javier said about making New Year's resolutions and such, those are the norm. But the sad thing is, if we made a New Year's resolution last year, it's kind of hard to remember what it was because we break them so quickly. They seem to fall by the wayside. But it's focusing on what God has called us to do and growing in it, as we even heard tonight. And that just keeps us going forward, like Brother Javier was sharing, just to go forward. So right now I'm going to ask you to bow your heads, and we're going to pray and open the altar. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time, Father, to gather in your name, to receive your word, Lord. We ask that you would bless, Father, our Brother Fernando, our Brother Javier, in a special way. You have raised them up as pillars in this body, as leaders, Lord. You've given them a heart of service to be here for your people, and we thank you for them. They're a tremendous blessing. They pour into, each one pours into our children, Lord, and even grandchildren, Lord, and you have placed them here to be used as tools in your hand. Continue to bless them and prosper them in the word and in their knowledge of the word and understanding, and continue to bless their families and use them, Lord. Continue to use them even more so in this new year. But we open the altar to you, Lord, just that if there is anyone here that needs prayer, that needs a touch from you, that doesn't know you as Lord and Savior, this is the opportunity. Father, we know that we aren't judged on whether we're good or bad, because your definition of good is perfect, and none of us can be perfect. So we need the blood of Jesus Christ to cover us, to wash us clean. So make us ready, Father. Continue to strengthen us, cover us, and have your way in this place. We just give you all thanks, all honor, and all praise. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. The altar is open. If there's anyone that needs prayer tonight, you come. You come. We'll pray with you. We have time. Thank you, Lord.
Tries to roll over my bones, and sorrow comes to steal the joy I own. Brokenness and pain is all I know. I won't be shaken, no, I won't be shaken. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance. I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love.
Tonight, sharing us these encouraging and challenging, Lord, words. Just pray that we would take them to heart. Lord, we pray for Pastor Mike's brother Ted tonight, Lord. He's having surgery. We pray that your presence would be with him, and we just pray that you would guide the surgeons, that they would do what you want them to do, Lord. May you strengthen him and his wife, Father. We pray for Brother Daniel and the family, that you would minister to them, Father, and comfort their hearts, Lord, in the loss of his brother, Lord. Also, Brother Marco and Sister Yolanda, Lord, with their son Miguel, Lord, that you would heal him, strengthen him, give him faith and hope. Use this, Lord, to strengthen him, Lord, to bring him closer to you. Help his wife, Lord, help his parents, Lord. May your grace be with them. Encourage us, Sister Christine, Lord, with the loss of her mother-in-law and her husband making plans. May you use her to bring your hope into this family, and also Sister Barbara, Lord. We just pray for all the brethren that aren't feeling well tonight. May you heal them. May you bless them. May you bless everyone that came tonight. May you be with each one of us as we go home. May your grace be upon us. We pray these things and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Brethren, thanks for being here tonight. God bless you. We'll see you, Lord willing, Saturday morning for church, for worship, for the word. And there's some cookies over there, so please don't make me eat them all, okay? Please. Enjoy. God bless you.